Let's revisit the semantics of LRVM and what it does. So this is a time axis. The application, when it calls the begin transaction primitive of LRVM, what LRVM does is it says, okay, the application is going to modify some portion of the memory. So let me create a memory copy of the old contents of the portion of the memory that this transaction is going to modify, and that's what is called the in-memory undo record of LRVM. In the body of the transaction, the program is doing normal program writes and they are going into the memory. No problem with that because LRVM has the undo record already stashed away. So all of these are writes to normal memory and there is no interaction with LRVM during this portion of the transaction code. Then the application reaches the end transaction, makes the end transaction call to LRVM. At that point, LRVM is going to write a redo record onto the disk when the transaction commits, because end transaction is synonymous with committing so far as LRVM is concerned. And therefore, at this point, the changes that have been made to virtual memory are written out as a redo log record and forced to the disk by LRVM. We know disk I/O is slow, and the more you do it, the slower will be the subsystem that is using these LRVM primitives, and that's why LRVM provides the no flush option in end transaction call, which allows an application to tell LRVM, write it out to the disk, but don't stop me from progressing further in my computation. In other words, the application is hoping that there won't be any failures that will result in all the changes that it recorded in memory not being forced to the disk. So LRVM is going to write out the redo log as a background activity, and the hope is that there won't be any system crash during the time that it takes for it to do, and this is what we called as the window of vulnerability when we talked about LRVM. So what the no flush option does is to increase the vulnerability of the system to power failures in favor of performance. And that's a calculated risk an application developer is taking if they specify no flush optimization in the end transaction. So on the other hand, if you're conservative, then what you would do is you let the end transaction have the normal transactional semantic, which is to say that at end transaction, force the write of the log into the disk to ensure that the log segment has been committed to the disk, and only then allow the application to proceed further. And at this point, at the commit point, the other thing that LRVM would do is, in addition to forcing the log record to the disk, it'll also get rid of the undo record, because undo record is no longer needed for this transaction since the transaction is successfully committed. And we know as a background activity, what LRVM does is to update the original data segments with the changes that have been recorded in the redo logs, because as you recall, the data segment contains the persistent data which have been brought into memory and modified during this transaction. And those changes had to be eventually persisted. Right now, they're sitting in the redo log records. And what the log truncation part of the LRVM library does is to read the redo log records and apply them to the data segment and get rid of the redo logs. So this is the log truncation or cleanup of the disk space that is done periodically by LRVM, because in the absence of crashes, you have to make sure that you clean up the disk every once in a while. So the upshot of LRVM implementation is there are three copies of the VM space done by LRVM to manage persistence for recoverable objects. Of course, it optimizes log force by delaying them at transaction endpoint, but in implementing LRVM, one of the biggest sources of vulnerability is power failure, because if you, in fact, use that optimization to defer writing out the log record to the permanent storage, then all the work that you did in this transaction may actually be wasted if, in fact, there is a power failure before this log force happens. Now, what does providing a battery-backed DRAM give you?